Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel, and in our today's video we will be solving another example which I have given to my students in their terminal exam, and it is one of the best examples once we talk about the process flow sheeting. So we have been given a plug flow reactor, a shortcut distillation column and two heat exchangers in this example to solve the overall system. So looking at the statement that the normal butane is to be reversibly isomerized to isobutane in a plug flow reactor, this reversible reaction is carried out isothermally in liquid phase under high pressure using a liquid catalyst. Feed enters at 330 Kelvin 15 atm with a flow rate of 100 kg mole per hour, and the feed contains 90 mole percent N butane, normal butane, and 10 mole percent isobutane, which we will select as 2 methyl butane. The reaction kinetics are as follows: that the units of activation energy are kilojoule per mole, and the reactant concentration is given in terms of molarity kg mole per cubic meter. So the reaction number one is that the normal butane converts to isobutane, and the value of K is 0.008639. The value of activation energy is 65.7, while the value of T naught is 360 Kelvin. And in the reversible reaction and the backward reaction, it is 0.003442, 72.6 kilojoule per mole activation energy. The percentage conversion of N-butane in the reactor and corresponding property package allocation for each group was obviously given, but in this case we will select pangrobinson as our required property package, and we will assume no pressure drop in the reactor, and the L by D ratio should be between 3 to 5. So we will select an average value of 4 for this process. Obviously it was different for different groups in the allocations. At the downstream of the reactor, we have to install a shortcut distillation column, and the objective is to achieve 0.1 kg mole per hour of I butane and 35.9 kg mole per hour of N butane in the bottom product. And we will select partial condenser as the column specification with a pressure drop of 0.5 atm in reboiler and 1 atm in the condenser. Accordingly, then we will install the heat exchangers and we will do the heat exchange process. So let's quickly go to the Aspen Plus. And first we will add our four components: N-butane, I-butane, I-pentane, water, with a property package of pangrobinson. We need to install plug flow reactor, shortcut distillation column and two heat exchangers to cool down top product and bottom product from the distillation column. So we will click here N-butane, then I-butane. We will select here. I-pentane cannot be selected here, so we will go here and we will select 2-methyl butane equals find now, and it is C5H12-2, add it, 2-methyl butane, and last water. Then click on this next. We will select pangrobinson as the property package, click on this next and then run, and once results are available go to the simulation environment. Now coming to the simulation environment, we will first add the reactor, that is the plug flow reactor given in our problem statement, and we will select it as plug reactor. We need to do its connections. Number one is the feed and then the product stream from the reactor. Now we have to first define the feed, and feed is in Kelvin and atm, so we will change the unit over here from METC bar to MET. And the feed conditions include 330 Kelvin temperature, 15 atm pressure, 100 kg mole per hour flow rate, mole fraction 0.9 and for N butane and 0.1 for 2 methyl butane. Then click on this reactor, and it's an isothermal reactor, so we will select the first specification as reactor with specified temperature and constant at inlet temperature. That will ensure that the system is isothermal in nature. Going to the configuration, no multi-tubular reactor, no diameter varies along the length, but we have been given the problem statement that L by D ratio to be between 3 to 5. So we will select an average value of 4. Accordingly, we will select length as 4 meter and diameter as 1 meter. However, in the valid phases, we will select it as liquid only, as we have been given in the problem statement that it's a liquid phase system. Then going to this reactions, click on this new R1, and it's a power law system. So click on this OK. Once we have done this, the reactor part is OK, but now we have to specify the reactions. So going to this reaction R1 and specifying both forward and backward reaction, N-butane goes to I-butane, coefficient -1 for reactant and exponent is 1 as per the rate law, and for this it is 1. Adding the second reaction, isobutane converts to n-butane, minus 1, exponent is 1, and coefficient for product is 1. Now going to the kinetic, and we will add these one by one. The reactive phase is liquid, since we have been given in cubic meter, so the rate basis will be the volume. The value of K for the first one is 0.008639, activation energy of 65.7 kilojoule per mole, while T naught as 360 Kelvin. To add the second one, click here, scroll it down, and add the properties of the second reaction, which is 0.003442 of K, activation energy 72.6 kilojoule per mole, T naught as 360 Kelvin. Once we have done that, run button is active, so click on this run to process it, and results are now available. Going to the stream results to check how much n-butane is converted to i-butane, mole flows. Initial flow rate was 90, final flow rate is 36.17375. So 90 minus 36.1735 divided by 90 multiplied by 100. So it is 59.81% conversion, which we have achieved in our process. Now we will add a column, which is the shortcut distillation column, and we will call it as COL, which is column, and double click on it and doing the required connection over here. And the top product, which we will call it as distillate and bottom. So once we have done that, now we will click on this column, and by default we know that we give the value of minus 1.3. The pressure drop in the condenser is 1 atm, while that of Henry boiler is 0.5 atm. Previously it was 15 atm and no pressure drop in the reactor, which means that the reactor outlet is at 15 atm. So here in condenser it will be 14 atm, and here it will be 14.5 atm. Now we have been given the partial condenser with all vapor distillate to be selected here. Now in the problem statement, if we go back, it is given that the separation objective is to achieve 0.1 kg mole per hour of i-butane and 35.9 kg mole per hour of n-butane in the bottom product. However, once we specify the recoveries in the column, it is of the top product. So what we need to do, we need to go to the Excel and we need to draw the complete material balance over there. So now as you can see that n-butane in feed is 36.17355, while in bottoms required is 35.9. So in top it will be calculated as feed minus the bottoms. Similarly for the i-butane, it will be feed minus the bottoms. Now we have known the top product flow rate, and to calculate the recovery, it is simply that component in the top product, which is n-butane, divided by in the feed. And similarly, that will be calculated for the i-butane. So i-butane is the light key in the top product, while n-butane is the heavy key in the bottom product. So going back, selecting as i-butane, n-butane, and simply copying it from Excel and doing that here. And once we have pasted it, reset it, run it, and now the results are available. So going to the stream results of the block, and we can see here that in the bottoms 35.9 k mole per hour of n-butane and 0.1 k mole per hour of i-butane is obtained here. So that part is also satisfied. Now we have to cool down these two distillate and bottoms here, and for this what we need to do, first we will cool one stream and then we will cool the second stream. So click on this exchanger, that will be HX1, and this distill will be the hot stream because it needs to be cooled down, and accordingly the water stream, which we will introduce over here now, will be W1 as our stream. This stream will go out as distill 2, while water stream will be W2 over here. So we have been given W1 as 298.15 Kelvin, 10 atm pressure, and accordingly the flow rate as 1000 k mol per hour. So that is entered over here. Now we need to go to this heat exchanger, and we have been given the minimum temperature approach is 10 Kelvin, and it is required that the feed temperature should be achieved here. Means that this distill 2 should be at the same temperature as that of the feed to the reactor, and that was 330 Kelvin. So what hot stream outlet temperature, it will be 330 Kelvin, and we have been given a pressure drop of 0.1 atm in hot side and 0.2 atm in the cold side. So again click on this reset, again run it, and once results are available, you can simply go to the thermal results to check that 330 Kelvin is obtained over here. There is a pressure drop of 0.1 atm at the hot side, while at the cold side it is 0.2 atm, and the water temperature is increased to 310.65 Kelvin. Now similarly, what we need to do, we need to install another heat exchanger over here, and that will be HX2. What we need to do, simply do the connections. Now the water outlet from the heat exchanger 1 is the water inlet of the heat exchanger 2. Instead of giving the fresh water stream, it will be W3 and it will be BTMs2. Accordingly, we can do the connections on the labeling part over here, as you can see here. And now again doing the same stuff over here, that 10 Kelvin is the minimum temperature approach. Hot stream outlet in this case is also 330 Kelvin, while the pressure drop at hot side is 0.1 atm, while that of the cold side is 0.2 atm. Again reset and run, and the results are now available for HX2 as well, and you can verify it by going to the thermal results as well. And there is a heat duty of 25,000 plus calories per second in heat exchanger number 2. So that's how we have simulated the overall flow sheeting to produce isobutane in the process. And you can see from here, by going to the stream results, that if we go to this mole fraction, that 99.5% isobutane is obtained in this process. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos.